Hello guys! Today I will unbox Aruba Access Point 11 and then configure on Aruba Instant On portal. These are the parameters of the AP11 device in the company's published datasheet. The maximum power consumption in the worst case is 10.1 W for PoE. AP11 uses 2x2 MIMO, which means that inside the device there will be two pieces of copper as a transmitting antenna to receive signals. Now I'm going to unbox these devices. This access point I bought at a Vietnamese distributor for about $100 with VAT. According to the manufacturer's announcement, Aruba AP11 is capable of supporting up to 50 devices at the same time. The compact AP11 weighs about 200 grams. The warranty will be effective as soon as you complete the installation and configuration of Aruba AP11 on Aruba Instant On. You should keep the purchase invoice and related documents as proof of warranty when necessary. The equipment inside the box is wrapped in outer pockets including AP11, user manual, two device mounts and about 1 meter LAN cable. DC power will not be equipped, you will have to retrofit it outside. In my opinion, today's access point devices mostly use PoE power instead of DC as in the past, it is handy. If you want to hang the device on the wall, you need to determine the installation location of the base. This location should ensure there is Wi-Fi coverage, then use a screwdriver to secure the base to the wall. Aruba Access Point 11 is easy to use and configure, you just need to watch this video and can do it without IT staff. The AP11 is designed to act as a wireless access point, WAP, providing Wi-Fi connectivity to mobile devices and laptops. Therefore, it does not need a LAN port to connect to other wired devices. In this video, I equipped a 5-port TP-Link switch to both level the network signal and power the devices. The cost of this device is also very cheap, I bought it for $25. Of the five ports of the device, one port will be the main line connecting to the building's modem, the remaining four ports will connect to AP11. I will plug in the power boot switch and connect the AP. Uplink's ports all support 1000 megabits per second, which will help increase the bandwidth emitted by these devices. I will use the LAN wire that comes in the box to plug it into the device. To make the device update the version for the first time. All devices are connected, now I will configure on Aruba Instant On. Create an account and access the website shown on the screen. We will select access point. Here there are two options. One is that you will divide the network from the provider's modem to the port of the switch and then to the access points. Two is that you will choose access point to connect directly to the modem provider. Depending on your purpose to be as optimal as possible, for my building I will choose option one so that the device can cover up to four floors of the building. You just need to enter the serial number of the access point and it will add to your account's Aruba Instant On. When you click search, the Aruba access points on your network are automatically displayed. Next, you set the SSID name to display and the login password. Successfully connected devices to cloud. The screen is displaying the version of the device when connecting to the internet for the first time. It will automatically update to the latest. The Aruba Instant On series will be free to use the cloud, meaning you can go to the company and still be able to configure devices at home through the portal. The traffic users' access will be managed and tracked on this device. I will connect to Wi-Fi and test how fast it is. All devices synced and updated to version 2.9.1. I will create one more Wi-Fi for free access for guest users. On Aruba, there will be additional support for Wi-Fi marketing feature. Check Wi-Fi enhanced open to be able to encrypt data for this type of Wi-Fi. After creating it, you can customize the login form when the user connects to Wi-Fi guest. So I have guided the successful configuration and installation of Access Point Aruba. In the following videos, I will do other topics about this access point. Thanks for watching.